Hi there. Here's a random setup which lets you control the amount of inflation of a cloth sim in Storm. First, create a basic cloth setup with a grid and a cloth solver. Don't forget to set run procedurals on subframes to true in the global settings. In the cloth solver, enable inflation and set cloth inflate to 1. Create an attribute set node and choose inflate as the name of the attribute. Set the type to scalar and value x to 10. Positive inflation values will push the cloth in the direction of the polygon normals. Negative values in the opposite direction. At the moment, the inflation attribute is set for every vertex of the mesh. We can mask that with the SDF volume. To do this, create a read node and load a mesh. Add a transform node to move, scale and rotate the mesh, and a mesh-to-volume node to convert the mesh to a SDF volume. Then plug the SDF volume in the second input of your attribute set node. To add soft edges to your mask, add a value to the distance mask fall-off, but don't forget to raise the SDF outer band in the mesh-to-volume node accordingly. If you want, you can also add a granular node for self-collision and colliders to your sim. I chose to create a collider for ground collision in this setup. As you can see, the connecting lines after the cloth solver are red. In Storm, red lines mark a dynamic chain. During simulation, Storm will loop through this chain for every substep and use the results of the previous substep for the next step. To end this chain, add an end dynamic node. If we run the simulation at this point, the vertices will keep the inflation attribute once it's set. To prevent this from happening, we can add another attribute set node, which resets the inflation attribute to 0.